Hey everyone, it's Damon here with Big AZ Speakers. Keeping in the spirit of 8-track, last night I showed a couple of Sony 8-track players that I was putting up for sale. So tonight, again in the spirit of 8-track and sticking with Waylon Jennings, last night we did old Waylon 8-track. So we'll do a little Waylon live. And look at this JVC. So I'm starting a little backwards, already got it taken apart. But here's the face for it, but it's a 4-channel plus a 2-channel recorder, so I don't see a lot of 8-track recorders. Model 4ED1205. So really good unit. Clean face, got done cleaning the face actually. Got a couple spots that need to be polished off. Probably can't see it. I do all this stuff in the middle of the night. It's about 4 a.m. here in Arizona, but went in, replaced the belt. So there's a little fan on top of the motor here. Undo the, so rather than try to stretch the belt over, just undo those 3 screws, pull the plastic fan off, and then slips right on. And then there's a counter, which this is a kind of unique unit because all the front inputs are mic inputs and a headphone. It's got front and rear. Of course, all this stuff actually screws directly to the faceplate. So take the face off, you gotta, and including the counter, but got the counter belt. So the counter belt goes on here, and then when this is hooked to the face, sorry. Only a couple things I'm good at doing one-handed. This isn't one of them. Anyways, so yeah, this belt just simply hooks onto here and wraps around the plastic pulley for the counter. All pretty simple. But just again, starting backwards, got it taken apart. Do some basic cleaning, clean the heads, but put this up for sale. So if somebody wants to further do the refurbishment of it, by all means, more power to them. But it's a good sounding, good playing unit. View meters work, all the lights work. These bulbs, I thought this one was out, it kind of slips in and out of the socket. So after it gets shipped to you, there's a chance you might have to retrace these steps, try to get it seated in there real good. But if the bulb for track 3 is not working, it's either track 3 or 2. Just know that that's the culprit. So my apologies in advance. So, but fun thing is why it's all disassembled, looking like something from Fallout, the game. It plays. So let's see. Thought I can load this one-handed without the that against there, make sure it's touching. So it doesn't have the face plates kind of hold it perfectly in place. There's how we change programs. And my 8-track cassette's in really bad shape. As you see, like the pads, if I turn my headlamp off, all need to be replaced. So, all that considered, the speed seems to be pretty consistent on this. Not a lot of note bending or whining or anything like that. Actually, really clear both channels. This is your front channels, it's only 2-channel. 8-track, I don't have a 4-channel, unfortunately. But, so, turn the left down, right all the way up.
left all the way up. Maybe if it says left on the right, so you just get the point. Both all the way up. So you can hear both channels. Sorry, I'm gonna get this thing put together and I'll finish this video off, but hopefully, the other problem I was having with it, and I did clean it, is the way the program switch works is it basically, turn my lamp on, it already is on. So basically this plastic guide here, or goes through here and just closes these contact for a second, but it wasn't working with the button all the time, so clean the contacts. Then anyways, all this is going around through here and ultimately working to actuate this. Find something that's not gonna electrocute me. All right, so I push this in. Everything's working good now. But just if you buy it and you have any issues with this, it was the ultimate cleaning these, and I think this got kind of bent out a little bit, so I realigned the contacts. It seems to be working pretty good. But then again, this is just plastic, so there's a chance that it got worn down a little bit. But it seems to be working pretty consistent now, so. As you see, this JVC really sounds awesome. For A-Track, I'm enjoying, I haven't had a dose of Wayland in a long time, so. Kind of making my Midnight Madness work a little more fun. So, but let me get this put back together so you can see what it looks like completed, and I'll let you go. But this is probably gonna be the end of my video. So, well, I don't know if I'll put this on this cut on the back end or put the assembled part on the back end. But anyways, if not, if this is somewhere in the middle, I apologize. But you can check us out at bigazspeakers.com. Again, that's big. And then AZ like Arizona speakers.com. Please give us a thumbs up. If you don't like the video, go ahead and hit thumbs down twice, and follow us if you want to see more videos, and check out our website. Thanks again. Stay tuned. All right, just checking in real quick. Got the face back on. A little bit more of a pain in the butt than most, and got it on twice, and first time I forgot to reseat the light bulb, and then the first time I forgot to put the program switch back in. So again, because all the mic and the headphones and stuff bolt onto the faceplate, everything, trying to get this aligned and the view meters, is a little more work than it need to be. So all I gotta do now is clean up the wood case and put it back together, and I'll continue the video. Alright, finally got it all together. All dolled up and assembled. You can see it's really beautiful. Has a couple scratches. It's hard to see on the top. I'm going to turn my light on. See right there. Otherwise, a little bubble on there, but pretty darn beautiful. Now, this is the second night in a row I've had to battle with rubber that turned to goop, but instead of being the belts on this one, it was the feet. So I took the feet off and replaced them. So I left a little bit of stain on the bottom, but scrubbed those suckers off and put these little
One's on, seemed like the right height. And overall, pretty impressed with this A-track player. Again, it's a 4-channel, but it's 2-channel recordable. I'm only playing 2-track, 8-tracks, that's all I got. But it's kind of neat, so you can play in a continuous loop or have it end at the end of each track. So track one, it'll stop. But non-stop mode, pretty neat. So just keeps playing and playing and playing, never have to rewind it the way the 8-tracks are wound. So I'm gonna turn it on. I went through and deoxid, cleaned all the controls.
They say that I can't last much longer. Little they see that the thoughts of me is my say. Little they know.
Pause. Program select.
I took my harpoon out of my dirty red fan teardrops. Sorrow you say.
So alright, thanks for tuning in. If you made it through the whole video, bless you, and again, be sure to follow us and give us a thumbs up and all that good jazz, and visit us at bigazspeakers.com. Thanks again and have a terrific day.